Do I try to fight my battles alone? Welcome to Coffee with Pastor B.
Come out of sadness from wherever you've been. Come brokenhearted, let rescue begin. Come find your mercy, oh sinner, come kneel. Earth has no sorrow that heaven can't heal. Earth has no sorrow that heaven can't heal.
You know, oftentimes as we go through this life, we're always trying to fight our battles alone. We're too embarrassed with what may be going on. We may be too afraid of what other people think or what they might say about us and these things. And, you know, I'm going to tell you, it's a good way to lose your battles. It's a good way to walk away from your friends. It's a good way not to have close relationships. I want to take you to Exodus chapter 17. And here in verse 11, just to set the stage, Amalek has come against the Israelites as they're coming out of Egypt. Moses just struck the rock so that they have the water. They've gone and they've battled against Amalek. And, you know, Joshua goes down to fight, but Moses stays back. And he's on top of a hill, and he's overwatching the battle. And every time he has his hands raised, you know, basically in praise to the Lord, as long as his hands are raised, they're winning. But when his hands begin to fall or he becomes faint, they begin to lose. And, you know, I wanted to set that stage for you because I want you to hear what's going on here. There's a battle being fought. There's a war raging here. And Moses needs to keep his hands up. That's his part in this battle, is his hands and raised in praise to God. And when they're up, they're winning. So let me just read this. It says right here, and it says in verse 10, Joshua did as Moses told him, and he fought against Amalek. And Moses, Aaron, and Hur went up on top of a hill. So it came about that when Moses held his hand up, that Israel prevailed. And when he let his hand down, Amalek prevailed. But Moses' hands were heavy. Then they took a stone and put it under him, and he sat on it. And Aaron and Hur supported his hands, one on one side and one on the other. Thus his hands were steady until sunset. So Joshua was overwhelmed Amalek and his people with the edge of the sword. See, when we're fighting our battles, we think we have to do it alone. We think that this is it's my battle, it's personal, I don't need to let anybody in. But I'm here to tell you, you really need people in your inner circle, is what we call it, in your inner circle, is at least what I call it. You need folks that know stuff about you. I'm not saying you need to put your life on public blast, every little thing going on in your life needs to be on public blast. What I'm saying is you need to have that two or three people that you can truly rely on, that you can truly count on, that you can share your life with, and that can fight the battles with you. You know, if Moses hadn't had Aaron and Hur on either side of him, they probably would have lost the battle because Moses' hands would have become so heavy he couldn't keep them up any longer. But they were there to support him, to encourage him, and in the end, to uplift his arms in the battle. Folks, we need people like that in our lives that aren't going to be there to judge us, to say, oh, look how weak sauce you are. Oh, look how hard. Man, you're just weak. You need to fight harder. You need to work harder. You need to try harder. We need people in our lives that are willing to grab our hands and lift them into the air and to hold them up for us as long as necessary. Sure, there's a time to hold our own hands up, and there's a time to hold others' hands up. But folks, I'm telling you, in your battle today, let others help to hold your hands up. God has given us each other. As we go into the New Testament and we see how Jesus created this, we just covered this in John chapter 19 on Sunday, where he looks down at John and he sees his mother there and he says, Mother, here is your son, and son, here is your mother. And he's giving them to each other because he knows they're going to need each other in the battle ahead. It's almost as if he's instituting the church right there at the cross to say, take care of one another, encourage one another as long as it is called today, it says in Hebrews. Lift each other's up. And further on in the Bible, it says, share each other's burdens, bear each other's burdens. That means lift each other's burdens up, bear them, carry them with you. Just like that her and Aaron were doing here in Exodus, do the same thing. Lift each other's arms up. Give glory to God, but lift each other up. Have those people that are willing to lift you up and be the person willing to lift others up. Thanks for joining me for just a sip of coffee and a look at the Word this morning. God bless y'all.